let's take a journey into imperialism, the process of creating an empire and taking colonies.
One of the greatest amounts of colonization took place in Africa during the late 1800s. In 1875, only 10% of Africa was colonized, but by the 1900s, 90% was colonized.
But why Africa? Africa had many natural resources, such as gold, diamonds, rubber, and other resources that appealed to European countries.
They also had markets, where the Europeans could sell their goods. Another reason was strategy. The European countries wanted to keep each other in check by taking colonies in strategic places so the rivals couldn't build bigger empires than they could. This also applies to the feeling of pride and superiority, by each of the European countries wanting to control more colonies and land than their rivals.
King Leopold II saw all the beneficial qualities of colonies as a great way to make money. He then took control of the Congo, making it the Belgian colony, the colony of Leopold's country, Belgium. His colony was the first major colony in Africa.
All other European countries saw how much money Leopold II was making and wanted colonies of their own. In the mad dash for land in Africa, war almost broke out between the nations of Europe. Therefore, the Berlin Conference of 1885 was held to resolve the land-dividing issues.
Another reason African colonization was that the Europeans had the belief that they had a duty to fix the Africans, as the Europeans believed that they were better than all the Africans combined. They also believed the Africans were nothing but savages and needed help. This belief is called the White Man's Burden.
This belief is shown well by this quote from The White Man's Burden by Rudyard Kipling. Your new-caught sullen peoples, half devil and half child. This shows that the Europeans believed the Africans were evil like the devil and irresponsible like children.
Imperialism was also taking place all around the world during the 1800s. Some of these places were India, China, and Japan.
To learn more about Africa, click here.
And to start learning about India, click here.